Sound design.
Now we all know that as a rule, as soon as you start taking any kind of measurement, someone has to turn on a vacuum or a forklift or some kind of noise to make an interruption. The way you are going to remain flexible so that you can respond to that is to be able to turn up the sound in the room or turn it down if the sound goes away, be able to make adjustments to your measurement signal in the room without actually changing the trace that you see, the measurement that you see on the screen. So this is a step in the audio analyzer verification checklist that I call the fader test. And it's simply that. I should be able to move up and down my reference signal fader to put more sound into the room, put more sound into the system, into the device under test, if I need to, without changing the trace here. Let me show you what I mean. So if I turn on a measurement here, if I turn on the signal generator, there's my measurement. I should be able to turn this down if I need to. And look at that, the trace doesn't move. Okay, it's still at about the same place. Let me save the trace so I can prove that to you. Okay, I saved it. And now if I move this fader down, I can hear the volume changing in the room. And you can see my voice when I talk. But see, the level doesn't change. Okay, and that's because I'm changing the copy of the signal at the same time as the measurement. So look at these meters right over here. Okay, they're moving together. So as long as the level that I'm sending back to my audio analyzer is the same as the level that I'm putting into the room and they're moving in sync like this, then the trace level that I see here in my amplitude trace is going to remain at the same level. Remember that I tap the signal right at the input of this matrix though. So if I turn this matrix down, the level is actually going to move. So I'll set this back to zero. And if I turn the matrix down, okay, see how the meters changed and my trace went down? Okay, now my measurement signal in the room is much lower than my reference. Okay, now it's louder than my reference, and it's gonna go above zero. This is where I started, and it goes back to the same level. All right, that is the fader test, and that again will allow me to just remain flexible in case I need to adjust the volume in the room, but then it won't mess up the offset of all of my traces that I've been working on.
Sound design.